أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله تبارك وتعالى نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وما قل ودل خير مما كثر وألهى، وقليل يغنيك خير من كثير يطغيك، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. وبعده، respected dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather us in the Jannah as He gathers us here every Friday and Saturday. Allahumma amin ya Rabbil Alameen. I would like to start my halaqa tonight with a story in Sahih al-Bukhari and in some other collections of hadith عن سيدنا علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه قال بعث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رجلا من الأنصار على سرية وأمرهم أن يطيعوه. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم told us we need to have leaders whenever we are traveling, for example, or in an organization we must have leaders. In a country, we have leaders. In the house, we should have leaders. And we should listen and obey to them, except if they ask us to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or they ask us to do something that's beyond our ability. As we explained last time, and today, inshallah, I'm going to continue talking about this concept, how to deal with the leaders. So, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he sent a group of sahaba, and they were traveling together. The narration doesn't say anything about their destination, but they were traveling together. That's what we're sure about. And he appointed someone, alayhi salatu wasalam, assigned him to be the Amir. You know, when you're traveling, you need someone to be responsible for the budget, the money, somebody to be responsible for food, somebody to be responsible for transportation, for example. Same thing. And we need to listen to those people and obey, because they are going to take care of our affairs. Same thing here. So Nabi Asam said, listen, اسمعوا وأطيعوا. Listen to him and obey him. فلما خرج وجد عليهم في شيء. At some point, he became angry with them. And he decided to take actions. I don't know why he became upset. Also, the narration didn't mention anything, but maybe he asked them to do something and they didn't obey him, or they didn't do it in the proper way, in ways. فَقَالَ So he said to them, أَلَيْسَ قَدْ أَمَرَكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَن تُطِيعُونِ Didn't the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ask you to listen and obey to me? قَالُوا بَلَى He said, نعم. Yes, he said that. قال فاجمعوا حطبا فجمعوا حطبا ثم دعا بنار فأضرمها في الحطب ثم قال عزمت عليكم أن تدخلوها. He asked them to kindle some fire. He asked them to burn to kindle some fire, to have some fire. And then he said to them, you need to listen and obey to your Amir, go and jump into the fire. فقام رجل من أحدثهم سنا. One of the youngest people stood up and said, يعني إنما اتبعتم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فرارا من النار. One of the youngest people, he said, you only came to Islam and you followed رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم so you would be saved from the fire. You came here to escape from fire, and he is asking you to jump into the fire. Then they said, actually, yes, we're not supposed to jump into the fire. When they came back to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Ya Rasulullah, we disobeyed our Amir." And then they told him the story. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لو دخلتموها ما خرجتم منها أبدا عليه الصلاة والسلام. النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام said, if you jumped in the fire after he asked you to do that, you would never be able to come out of the fire. You will stay in the fire until the day of Qiyamah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So why am I mentioning some ahadith like this at the beginning of my halaqa? Because when we mention the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that tells us to listen and obey to our leaders and our rulers, some people say, يعني هؤلاء دعاة السلطة. They say those people are very loyal to the government and they want us to follow our leaders and the authority and not to say our opinion and to be oppressed and to be happy with that. If Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to us, go fight against your rulers, we would say that. Why would you hide something like that? But he said alayhi salatu wasalam something else. He said, listen and obey to them, except if they ask you to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what we say, and that's what we will continue to say, regardless of what people think. Because that's what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said. So we'll continue, inshallah, some ahadith, and then go to another point, to those people who are looking for authority, and looking for leading people, whether it is in a country or in a community, small community like our community, and they are not qualified yet to lead people. They don't have the leadership skills, the enough skills to lead people. One of these ahadith, for example, is reported by Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim عن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنها ستكون بعدي أثرة وأمور تنكرونها. نبي عليه الصلاة والسلام said, after I pass away, after I go, you will see some discrimination, you will witness some discrimination. An أثرة means الاختصاص بحظ دنيوي. أثرة means when somebody is not qualified and he is an authority. Like we admit sometimes, not every single person in every leading position in the world is qualified. Nobody said that. We agree because the Nabi Asam said that. He said, أثرة. You will find some people who are not qualified and they are in some leading positions. عليه الصلاة والسلام. And then he said, وَأُمُورٌ تُنْكُرُونَهَا. And they will do some stuff to you that you have never seen before. You'll disapprove what they're doing. So we agree on this. Not all of them are good people. قَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ كَيْفَ تَأْمُرُنَا أَوْ كَيْفَ تَأْمُرُ مَنْ أَدْرَكَ مِنَّا ذَلِكَ. Ya Rasulullah, some of us will live after you pass away. What are you going to command us to do? What's your commandment? فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تؤدون الحق الذي عليكم وتسألون الله الذي لكم. He said, fulfill your obligations, do what you have to do, your responsibilities, and then go fight with them to take your rights. No. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, and ask Allah for your rights that you deserve. And ask Allah for your rights that you deserve. Because actually everybody is hurt because of what's happening in our Muslim world. And when I mention this ahadith, I really feel and think about what's happening in our Muslim world. And people rebel against their rulers and they destroy their countries. Because they don't think that what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying is enough for us. No, we have to change what's evil with our hands. But you have some other step. You can change it with your tongue if you can't. And if even you can't speak, and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave you another chance to change it, with your heart, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. No, I want to change it with my hand. And I want to be an authority. But Rasulullah said the opposite. I don't care. And then always what happens after they rebel against the rulers is always of the time worse than what was before. As Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said. Another hadith, عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من أطاعني فقد أطاع الله. Whoever obeys me obeys Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ومن عصاني فقد عصى الله. And whoever disobeys me disobeys Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ومن يطع الأمير فقد أطاعني. And whoever obeys the Amir, the leader, the ruler, obeys me صلى الله عليه وسلم. ومن يعص الأمير فقد عصاني. And whoever disobeys his Amir, he is disobeying me, alayhi salatu wasalam. And if you disobey Rasulullah, it means you're disobeying Rabbil Alameen. So very clear. Very clear rulings and qawa'id that he's giving us, sallallahu alayhi wasalam. The last one, last hadith I will mention in this meaning, and then we'll go to some another point. Okay, I'm not going to rebel against him, I'm not going to fight or anything, but I'm just going to insult him or just always say something bad about him, you know. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to destroy them all. Okay, if Allah destroys them all, He will destroy you with them because you actually live there. No, I just will make dua against them. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Reported by Imam al-Tirmidhi عن أبي بكرة, not أبي بكر الصديق, أبي بكرة رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من أهان السلطان أهانه الله. Whoever insults the rulers, Allah will insult him. عليه الصلاة والسلام. Doesn't need more explanation. But you still can make dua against the unjust ruler. Because Nabi Asam said, وَاسْأَلُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي لَكُمْ. In the hadith that we just mentioned, and ask Allah for your rights. So go complain to Rabbil Alameen, ask Him whatever you want, and tell Allah what you have in your heart, but don't go insult and rebel and cause troubles. Okay, next point, is about asking for leading positions. There are some people who are really, really very hungry for authority. And once they get it, they don't know how to lead people. You need to be qualified. If you're hungry like that for authority, you need at least to be qualified. No, he doesn't have any leadership skills. He just wants to be in a leading position. Maybe he's sincere. Nobody knows. Maybe he just wants to be seen by people. Nobody knows. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in their hearts. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن أبي سعيد عبد الرحمن ابن سمرة قال قال لي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. عبد الرحمن بن سمرة one of the صحابة in صحيح البخاري. He said النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said to me one time, يا عبد الرحمن ابن سمرة لا تسأل الإمارة. عبد الرحمن, do not ask for a leading position. Do not ask to be in authority. فإنك إن أعطيتها عن غير مسألة أعنت عليها. Because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants you, if you're granted the authority without asking, people actually are pushing you to run for elections. If you're granted the authority without asking, you will be helped. You will be helped by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أُعِنْتَ عَلَيْهَا. وَإِنْ أُعْطِيتَهَا عَنْ مَسْأَلَةٍ وُكِلْتَ إِلَيْهَا. And if you're given the authority because you asked for it, you will be left alone for it, to deal with it. Go deal with it yourself. Because you're the one who asked for it, and you think you're qualified enough and you have the ability to do it, خلاص, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to help you, you go take care of that. Next hadith, Sayyidina Abu Dharr al-Ghifari radiallahu anhu, and inshallah we'll end up with this hadith and mention one ayah, and that's it for tonight. Inshallah Rabbil Alameen. This hadith that we're mentioning, it has more than one narration. One narration is in Sahih Muslim. عن أبي ذر رضي الله عنه قال قال لي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And in some, the other narration he said, قلت للنبي ألا تستعملني. Abu Dharr came to النبي عليه الصلاة and said, يا رسول الله, would you use me in a leading position? He thinks رضي الله عنه that he can lead people and he had the leadership skills. يا رسول الله, use me to lead people. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أبا ذر إني أراك ضعيفا. I think you're a weak man and you're not qualified yet to lead people. إني أراك ضعيفا. And then he said صلى الله عليه وسلم وإني أحب لك ما أحب لنفسي صلى الله عليه وسلم. And والله يا أبو ذر, I love for you what I love for my own self, عليه الصلاة والسلام. So what does he love for himself? He said that after. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تأمرن على اثنين. Don't rule over two people. Don't try to be a leader, an amir, even for two people only. Not for a community, not for a whole country. Just for two people, because it's an amana. Allah will ask you about it. لا تأمرن على اثنين ولا تولين مال يتيم. And do not manage an orphan's property. It's allowed to manage an orphan's property and take care of him. And this allowed to be a leader. But Nabi Asim is saying it's so dangerous and it's an amana and it's very heavy on our shoulders on the day of Qiyamah. It's amana. The other narration is in عليه الصلاة والسلام وإنها يوم القيامة خزي وندامة إلا من أخذها بحقها وأدى الذي عليه فيها. And on the day of Qiyamah you will regret it. You will regret that you had an authority in that dunya except for those people أخذها بحقها وأدى الذي عليه فيها. They fulfilled their obligations and they give people their rights while they were in authority. The last ayah inshallah will end up with قال الله عز وجل يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم وأولي الأمر منكم. And he didn't say أطيعوا the third time. سبحانه وتعالى. أطيعوا الله, obey Allah. And then he repeated the same order, the same word. وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ. It means, sometimes you'll find some rulings in the sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم that doesn't exist in the Qur'an and you still have to obey it. Because it's Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is saying. Because, you know, Al-Qur'aniyun, he said only the Qur'an. Did you read the Qur'an that you say that you're following? If you only read this ayah, أَطِيعُ اللَّهِ, follow Allah, obey Allah, أَطِيعُ. And then the Rasulullah has وَأَطِيعُ by himself, وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ. How would you say only for the Qur'an? It's not possible. So أَطِيعُ اللَّهِ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ. He also can legislate by himself, صلى الله عليه وسلم, if it's an authentic hadith. And then وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ. And he didn't say وَأَطِيعُ. It means those leaders cannot legislate and they cannot issue rules, halal and haram, from their own selves. And if they do that against the will of Allah or the will of His Messenger, we will not obey that. Clear. وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ. So طَاعَتُهُمْ تَابِعَةٌ لِطَاعَةِ الرَّسُولِ. We follow them as long as they follow Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. Otherwise, we're not supposed to. جزاكم الله خيرا وأقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.